Now these ultra light airplanes are designed and built to be flown exactly as we're doing here. They fly in a circle in a nice big hangar or gymnasium, and the point is how long can these airplanes stand off?
Sandy, what's your record on the mini stick for time of law?
Now, like I said, those airplanes, the ultralight vapors that they're flying before, those are very fine, right out of the box, you just plug it in, you get on, you charge the battery off, and that thing is ready to go. This is a little different story. Building, trimming, designing the supply, so there's absolutely no input from the operator. What slides up and what's it done? This airplane is going to do what it's going to do. Adjustments and modifications to the shape of the airframe itself by bending the elevators and monitors and motors to modify exactly as you want. Of the rubber band with one of these indoor flyers. Again, I gave you some statistics on how these are built earlier. The frame itself is 1/16 inch square balsa. We have a few pieces circulating around the audience. The covering on this, the ultra film, it's 3/10,000ths of an inch thick. That's 0.3 millimeters. It weighs 0.0028 ounces per 100 square inches. This stuff is so thin that you can't even cut it with scissors. It has to build up. Now the advent of these ultra micro turbos and the small, very lightweight, powerful electric motors, it really opened up entirely new avenues for remote control pilots. It allows anyone with a large space. I know some of you love to buy local school gyms to fly it. They have an entire remote control playground for a shop in Oakland Bay. They have indoor high, they have indoor tracks, indoor and Bob just slots that back down in a couple of seconds and he's ready to continue the show. We'll call that a touch and go.